something inside of me tells me that being homosexual is probably wrong.
God loves you, honey. God loves you.
you've definitely got a complicated relationship with your sexuality. I'm going to read out something you wrote about homosexuality. The feelings of alienation and rejection it engenders are responsible for the sorts of repugnant tribal posturing you see on the streets of Soho on a Friday night, as bitterly unhappy queers engage in degrading and repulsive behaviour.
I stand by that.
Okay.
Straight people do that in Soho as well.
Well,
I mean,
definitely there are definitely there's plenty of straight people posturing. So, but that reads like. That reads basically like the words of a homophobic gay man.
It's quite self-loathing.
It's not the first time I've been called that.
Well, no, it's not the first time.
I'm not surprised. I don't think in the piece that was in, I think the context was very much that growing up gay is not easy. It's not a happy life for most people. And I think that gay marriage is another one of those things that helps to reinforce to people that it is a perfectly acceptable, normal, possibly even desirable lifestyle choice.
I don't believe that. Growing up ginger, small, big, you know, having a pair of glasses, it's all difficult. You know, being a kid is difficult.
But being gay is one of the most difficult
things. No, I got picked on at school and called names, but I love being gay. And if it was a choice, I'd choose it again. Mm. You know, I think, you know, it's about... Well, you should be happy. I want you to be happy. That, when I read that, I just feel like, you know, you're not happy being gay. And it's just...
Well, no, I'm not. I've said so.
But you should be. It's a fantastic lifestyle. Well,
I know that day-to-day it has some wonderful advantages. And I enjoy some of them.
I think equality kind of starts with you.
But I think if you're going to say all else being equal, you would choose to be gay again, that sort of horrifies me.
But it horrifies you.
But isn't the situation though, whether you don't get to choose whether or not you're gay, but in a nice, happy
society, it shouldn't matter.
You can own it. I think there's something to be said for owning your life experience and saying, you know what, this is what I am. Isn't it great? Let's make the most of it.
If it's your coping strategy for dealing with it.
I don't feel like I'm coping. I actually... You know, I think it's about customising.
Do you know what? I think you are coping. But the thing is, though, society's really changed. Most people used to think it was wrong to be gay, that if you had that inclination, you should suppress it. Mm. Our views in society have changed. It seems to me that the view of the Catholic Church hasn't changed to the same extent. Surely that's not something we should defer to. That's something we should rightly reject.
Well, there's an argument that, you know, religion is religion, it has rules, it is a set thing. You know, maybe it's not always such a good thing that it bends to the fashion of the times.
If I could choose, I wouldn't be homosexual.
Really?
That doesn't make me self-loathing.
So if someone came out with a pill, a Pfizer...
Came out with a pill to...
It does.
No, it doesn't.
You
no,
don't think
doesn't.
It makes you self-loathing
Absolutely
to
not.
Hate a part of what you
I
are?
I don't hate a part of what I am. I love all of me, but if I could choose to be even better, then I would be.
So you'd be better if you were straight?
Yes.
Wow.
Anybody would be.
If Johnson
and
Johnson
would be better if
came along
straight.
And had an anti-gay pill,
yeah,
you would take it.
Well, it would be career suicide, but I probably would. Yeah.
You said in a conversation with Joe Rogan that you would choose not to be gay if you could, and that everyone should. Can you expand on why this is and answer whether or not you think others can choose their orientation?
Well, there's so the gay lobby started a big lie in the 80s. Now, the religious right was saying that homosexuality was a sinful lifestyle choice. It was an immoral way to behave, an immoral set of decisions that you were making. It was based on Christian doctrine that, you know, you hate the sin, not the sinner, right? So you can love this person, but what they do is not making God happy. So Christians would say homosexuality is a sinful lifestyle choice. The gay lobby were kind of stumped by this because, of course, according to Christians' own set of values, yeah, it is. There's not much, no way you can go from that, really. So what they did is they kind of came up with this gay gene thing. It's like, wait a minute. What if we're like black people? What if we were born this way, and we've got no way to change it? That would make everybody who doesn't like us into the most massive bigots. Let's go with that. So they invented Born This Way, which is now a cultural trope, even in, you know, a couple of years ago in Lady Gaga's songs. But it's a lie. It's not true. The science suggests that it's a mixture of nature and nurture. Steven Pinker thinks it's mostly nurture. In my own experience, it's certainly mostly nurture. I think when I said on the show, if I could choose to be not to be gay, I probably would. I meant it because it's more difficult being homosexual. I mean, I get a lot of mileage out of it, but I'd quite like to have kids, and I'm not sure that I want to bring kids up in a gay household because so much of sexual orientation is nurture. I don't want to be responsible for, you know, for him or her not having the best possible, easiest life. I mean, if we could choose, we would all have our children, you know, heterosexual, if only to give them a happier, better chance in life, better start, to spare them pain. For myself, like I said, I'm kind of stuck in the rut now. I try it once a year just to make sure that I still don't like it. I find a willing volunteer. And it's never much fun. I get bored after 10 minutes. I'm like, no. I probably would have changed it. If I could take a pill and change it overnight, maybe. Probably not now, because it would be professionally disastrous. I have to wait a few years. You know what I do want to do, though? I do want to do that pray the gay away therapy, just to see if it works. Because lots of people say it works, and lots of people say it doesn't work. And people say it doesn't work, it's always bigoted, hateful, religious, you know, nonsense. But there are just as many people who you will never hear about because the media doesn't want to report on them, who say, yeah, transform my life. I've got a wife, and I've got kids, and I'm happy now, and I wasn't before. There are all kinds of explanations that, you know, the left will come up with, as, you know, well, you've just internalized bigotry or whatever. But I'd quite like to try it and see.